10 o'clock, we will call meeting to order. For the couple of weeks.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Approval of the minutes from our last meeting. Moved and seconded. Any additional comments, questions? Not all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Minutes approved. Bills. We have a list of bills. In a packet and on our desk. Any questions on the bills?
I'll make a motion to approve the bills.
Second.
Been moved and seconded that we pay the bills. Roll call, please.
Holt. Brown.
Aye.
Wakefield.
Aye.
Lightcon.
Aye.
Britt.
Aye. Motion carries. Financial report. Everybody should have received the financial report in their packets as well. Any questions? Everything looked good, I thought.
New year.
It's a new year.
Move to approve.
Second.
It's been moved, it's been seconded to approve the financial report. Roll call, please.
Brown.
Aye.
Wakefield.
Aye.
Lightcon.
Aye.
Holt.
Aye.
Britt.
Aye. Treasurer's checks.
Moved to approve.
Second.
We've been approved that we approved the treasurer's checks listed. All in favor, roll call, please.
Wakefield.
Aye.
Brown.
Aye.
Holt.
Aye.
Lightcon.
Aye.
Britt.
Aye. Approval of the agenda. Any additions to the agenda for today?
Moved to approve.
Moved and seconded to approve the agenda. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Approve year-end budget amendments. Everybody has a copy of the budget amendments on their desk. I thought for the most part they looked really, really good. Quite a few under budget. A few over, but.
Not bad.
Not bad.
When they were transferring floors basically the LEC, which is pretty good.
Right.
And we were pretty much spot on.
Was it this year or next year that we can start closing out those old flood damage accounts?
Any year. Up to 2011. We have the key 2011. Anything below that.
Because I mean, when was the last time that anybody claimed 2009 or 2010?
See, the money left there, I know the cost was the administrative money. And they never put any restrictions on how that was to be used. Other than you can't buy equipment.
But we could use it for road projects or
right.
Put it back in the general or whatever we want to do.
Yeah. Let me just have a bunch of it.
We have a motion to approve the year-end budget amendments. Is there a second?
Second.
Moved and seconded to approve the budget amendments for the year-end. Second roll call. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. First of the year business, we have some motions that Candy has included in our packets for operating for the upcoming year. First one would be to board meet on all matters pertaining to various offices, undertakings, unless authority is granted to an individual member of the commission to act for the board, and that the county auditor is authorized to pay all regular bills such as monthly salaries, lighting, water, telephone, bills with discount along with Mountain Lake Human Service Zone and indirect bills when received. Be the first one.
I'll make that one.
Moved by Commissioner Lightbound.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Wakefield. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. The next item of business is no county official or employee shall order equipment, supplies, or services amounting to $2,000 or more without permission from the county commission, except for emergency supplies that department supervisors will deem necessary to authorize. Motion by Commissioner Brown, second by Commissioner Bolton. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Next item is designated depositories. Ramsey National Bank and Trust, Bremer Bank, and Western State Bank, all at Devil's Lake, be designated as depositories for Ramsey County. A motion for that?
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Commissioner Wakefield, second by Commissioner Lightbound. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Next item is Ramsey County Treasurer be authorized to invest county funds as soon as available and cash in investments when necessary.
Moved to approve.
Moved by Commissioner Brown.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Lightbound. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. The last one would be to set the amount of $5,000 for county fixed assets.
Move to hold.
Moved by Commissioner Brown. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second by Commissioner Wakefield. Any further discussion on that? If not, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Sarah, big day for extension today.
Yeah, we do. We have our live roundup today, virtually. So it's been a learning process for all of us. We have actually 4 speakers today. We start at 9 o'clock, and we have about 200 people registered. You need to pre-register for this event. And we're really excited. We start with the 2021 marketing outlook and planning in a pandemic. And the next speaker will be If Only. We've got Dawn Chisholm. She's going to talk about grain bin entrapment. She's a very motivating speaker. She actually lost her husband due to a grain bin entrapment, so she should be very good to listen to today. Farming Without the Bank will be next, and then our last one will be Daryl Richardson with the 2021 weather outlook. So we're really excited for today's presentations, and then our pre-recorded presentations are still available on our website. We have about 40 of those available. They're through tomorrow, so check those out if you haven't already. And also, we kicked off our shooting sports yesterday. We had our first couple of classes. We've got about 50 kids registered. So between Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays, we've got them all kind of spread out between numerous classes. So we're really excited to get those kids back to doing that again and get back in the shooting sports rhythm. So we're kind of looking forward to getting today kicked off at 9 o'clock too. So. Anybody have any questions in the extension world?
Thank you very much. Good job with that roundup. It's different than trying to find a further place to park this morning.
I know, yeah, and the food, exactly.
And the food. it smelled like somebody was making breakfast out there this morning, but yeah.
Not for us.
Not for you guys. Well, thank you so much for everything that your office is doing throughout this pandemic.
Okay.
Thanks, Tom.
Yep, you're welcome.
Kevin.
Start off, I guess we'll review the 5-year roadmap. So our first page is our graveling project. Of course, we just moved last year's project that was off. We only have one load of gravel this year. It's old turn back 17 by Starkweather. And I've sent the letters out to the townships to tell them what their share will be. See if we get their approvals. Any questions on that page?
What happens if they don't approve
it? I guess we just don't do it. That's why it's better to pass.
That's a pretty reasonable cost for the township.
Township share is 25% of the project, and it's split by two townships because it's a line there, so it'll be 12.5% each. So yeah, it's not money for a 6-mile project. And then on the second page, we have our big projects, our paving projects. This year we're just doing the design work on Ramsey County 3, and then the CIOI 17. And then next year, the even years, is when we do the construction. And of course, we moved last year's project to the bottom of the list. Any questions on that page? On the end of that page, or on the end of those columns, you see the average daily traffic. We haven't had a chance to update those lately. I'm not sure why that didn't get done. Next year we'll be updating all of them again for sure. We're getting behind.
How current are those?
2016. So yeah, they are. I'm sure some of the traffic patterns have changed in some of these. For instance, Ramsey County 8 over there by Bottom on the gravel section. Lately there's been a lot of trucks running over there. I haven't seen that in the past, like in 2016. So it'll be interesting to see what the count does over there.
Have any idea what was going on Ramsey 2? Some of those years were incredibly high for traffic counts. 2004, I think they had 1,200 average daily.
It might have been the condition of the highway. I honestly don't know why the jump, but
I wonder if there was construction going on or
something
else and having to rework or something.
Sometimes you can put them on for a week, and sometimes you get the right week, like a holiday week or something like that.
True.
So you just gotta take an average of the whole 5, 10 years, and 5, 10 counties, I should say.
I mean, Rutland was the highest one by far.
Highway 1 out here, where the lake was, right here, busiest one. And of course, Cove Road is a township road, it's not on here, it gets up there too. Any other questions on that second page? Third page is our chip seal project. This year we'll be chip sealing 3A, which is from Hamlin to State 17. Also, 9C, which is over eastern side of the county on Ramsey. And of course, last year's project just went to the bottom. One estimated 19 miles on that project, so I'm estimating 425,000. Any questions there? And the last page is our bridges. This year we plan to replace 4 of them. We normally do 3, but that third one and the fourth one are only like half mile apart, so we're just doing both at the same time. One's on the Tower County line, one's on the Cavalier County line, way up there in the northwest corner of the county. And we'll be getting help, shared costs on both of those from both counties. And the other two are kind of out in the wilderness. I mean, there's really no good road that leads to them.
What's the county share on the county?
On bridge structures, we take care of all of it. Kind of our policy is anything over 36 inches we supply, and then they're responsible for installation maintenance. But when you get to a navigable waterway, then we take over all of it.
Which is always an interesting term.
Yeah, sometimes there's a great line.
What's navigable?
So then when we get those, if you go down to that fifth one in 2021, that's our bridge we're going to be replacing on Ramsey Forest off of 17, our Frigies. That's in the design stage for this year. And the construction stage for next year. And I put estimates on what I figured that was going to cost also. But then when we get those ones done, in 2022 we'll only have like one that's in really poor condition, Cato, or this one in Cato doesn't get used at all. I don't even think the hunters use this one. So I don't know if this one will be able to get by with not putting colors back in or not. That's kind of a local decision, or the water board helps decide to. Then after that one, we've only got a few left to do. There's still, everything we got left now is big enough that they're being inspected by the engineers, so we get charged for that. So the more of these we get replaced, the better off we are that way. It's another charter, another inspection we won't have to do every year to pay for that. Any questions about bridges? I guess if that's okay with everybody, then we're looking for a motion to accept the changes that I made.
So,
second.
Moved and seconded to accept the 5-year road plan. Any further discussion?
Can I ask just one question? It's not necessarily on the road plan, but would there be some benefit, you know, we did the base stabilization work on the truck route. Would there be some benefit to maybe trying that on some of the other pieces of the gravel in the county? In small sections or stuff like that? Like you said, that stretch of eight that runs east a lot, it seems to always get soft in those two spots. Does it make sense to maybe try that in those spots or,
sure.
You know, maybe give it, I mean, we got a little bit of extra money back from the feds for the coronavirus stuff, plus we got some cash sitting in the bio flood money. Maybe we should attempt to do a couple spots and see if that helps or something. Because it seems like we continually get complaints on those.
Well, on the seven, some soft spots.
Yeah, seven's got some soft spots. Maybe it would make sense to try base stabilizing. You don't have to do a whole dog on road, but, you know, just those spots. Plus, it'll help to reshape it and get a nice crown on it again, maybe. Mm-hmm. It would be a good maybe try that a little bit. But
how is seven, Kevin?
Is it firmed up for the winter?
It's pretty good.
Yeah, it's real good. In fact, there was one kind of a dip towards the west end, east end. That was the only thing in the whole 10-mile stretch, so it wasn't that very detailed, you know. So,
yeah.
It got washboardy like every other road. It didn't have the soft spots anymore.
Is there a culvert there where that soft spot is?
No.
Old culvert?
No. I don't know. It was probably a soft spot that never got repaired, and it just had a dip in it. It's not really like a hog wall or something like that.
Was that fabric down or whatever? That help?
We did fill it in before it started freezing, and that helps. I mean, it helped fill the dip in a little bit, but it did freeze down like it should.
Blend some of that concrete in or something like we did with the grinders?
Yeah, we could do that. This is one. We had it marked, but we just ran out of time.
I think like seven has quite a few spots like that where it's just, it's
a little short.
Nobody's fault. It's just, I think the underbelly of the road is just, it's soft around it.
There's one road you get calls on, it's that one.
Yeah. You get multiple. I mean, I drove it last fall and it was a pretty good shape.
It was pretty fair?
Yeah, it was pretty fair at that point, I thought. But it seems like, for instance, on the west, yeah, the west end where you get close to where it runs into four there.
Is it four?
Yeah. You know, we fabricated the whole bottom of the slough through that big water run. So that's in nice shape, but then what happens is it just pushes everything out to the edge of the fabric and then it gets soft out there. So right. The main run through the middle is pretty good, but the edges get a little soft.
Right, right where the fabric ends.
Yeah. Is it just so the fabric works, but yeah. You almost have to maybe put more up, or I don't know. But, there's different options, but I'm just saying we've got a little bit of extra money sitting around. Maybe it would be beneficial to put a plan together to try to do some of those little spots to see if we can get them in better shape.
Would that work, Kevin? Would we fit that in?
Like on the truck road?
Adam's idea.
Yeah, I mean, the truck road's really hard. Yeah.
I just think it would make sense maybe on that little stretch on the east end of 8 and there's some few spots on 7, you know, try some spots like that if we can get it to move around. I mean, it seemed like the truck route worked pretty well, so we could do it the same. Yeah, just a thought.
We've been putting bags of the cement, I guess you call it, in the soft spots also. That does help, but it's just you can't catch up to it.
I will agree, help on the Ford one more on the ground.
Yeah, it helps.
That's for sure.
That's kind of a combo of different things, you know. Every time there's a small spot, you can use the concrete.
Which a concrete works with a little one.
Yep.
It's really time consuming if you got a half mile stretch.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's where I think it would make sense, at least in my mind, that some of those longer ones to maybe try doing, you know, because we did 3 miles of base stable on the truck road for $50,000 or something like that.
For
$90,000. So, I mean, spend, you know, do another couple, 3 miles out on those other roads and maybe spend $75,000-$80,000 or something. Shots.
Who did that for us? Close?
IBI was grinding it. They had their tiller or their grinder.
Yeah, that's something we should probably look into.
I like it too because it, especially like on the truck route, well, the truck route was okay to start with, but it, you know, then they reform it when they get it done and pack it, and it gets that nice crown again, so you get it set up again so it doesn't, you know,
it's water.
And I think that's part of the problem we've talked about over on 8, where you keep dumping and keep dumping and keep dumping, and then they drive across it, and then it just pushes it all out to the edges, and then you got holes, and then it rains, and the water sits, and then they don't you know, and they're gonna drive on it again. So then it's just a bigger hole and we're constantly chasing it. It's just like, maybe if we could get out in front of it, maybe it would help us a lot.
I think that's key right there, get out in front of it.
Yeah. But just a thought. Sorry to run us off.
Good discussion. Any other discussion on the 5-year road plan? If not, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion approves. Thank you, Kevin. Security cameras.
Yeah, it includes the quotes of the package for the quotes of God. NDTC was a lower bid. And they go there and they ask for it.
How much?
$6,594.05 for 5 cameras and a monitor and a hard drive or a computer for a...
What kind of warranty comes with it anyway?
3-year.
In the left.
They gave us the option to rent it also, but I'm not thinking about that.
What's the rent?
$150-$35 a month. Wouldn't take longer. Almost about $6,500.
Yeah, three-year worth.
They'll service it and everything up, Kevin? They'll take care of it?
Yeah.
Should be a long time to...
Unless it's under warranty, that type of thing.
I was gonna say, because are these similar cameras to what we put in around here then? So basically the same clarity and everything like that, and it just would have its own separate hard drive and not as many cameras. And like you mentioned, we extended the one on the courthouse to 5 years, I believe, for pretty cheap money. So maybe it would make sense to see if we could extend the 3 to 5 if we're gonna do something.
Yeah,
I think that's reasonable. I mean,
good idea.
We did it on the ones here because it was pretty affordable, I think. I can't remember what it was, but it was really reasonable. Yeah, it was really reasonable for another couple of years of warranty. And I guess I've looked at the system that they installed here, and the
pretty
quality
amazing.
Of it is really, really good. The hand quality and everything, I mean, it's a really good system. At least, I don't know anything about it, but as you can see what's happening, it means you must know what's going on. Yeah, the pictures look good, so.
Well, Chris helped me quite a bit with this. So.
Yeah.
So thanks for the question on that. You had a couple extra years on it.
Yeah. I'll make the motion to approve that.
Okay.
Been moved in second to accept a bid from North Dakota Telephone Company for the security camera system of the highway department. Any further discussion? If not, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign.
Well, one thing I have to add is, sorry, we have an invoice from KLJ for engineering services for preliminary work on that, designing that bridge for Ramsey 4, and the amount of $6,895.10.
Who do it?
Second.
Moved and seconded to approve the bills for KLJ engineering, and that's on the bridge on Ramsey 4.
Yep. We have a contract with them, this is just the invoice.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign, or should that be...
Let's say, are we actually paying it?
Paying it, or we... Okay. Roll call, please.
Wakefield.
Aye.
Brown.
Aye.
Holt.
Aye.
Lightfine.
Aye.
Griff.
Aye.
Going up.
Yep.
Japanese. Unfinished business, COVID-19 discussion. Is the everybody can see, numbers have been coming down throughout the state as well as in Ramsey County, which is great news. News yesterday was the governor's changing our statewide status from orange to yellow, which is going to include some increased capacities for bars, restaurants, event centers, up to 65%, no more than 200 people, I think. School started in-person fans yesterday for their sporting events in town. I think each participant gets two vouchers to get to whoever they choose. Social distancing obviously included in that. Talked to Annette yesterday. She said vaccinations have been going well. They've been getting a weekly supply of vaccinations, and they're not sitting on them, they're getting them in the arms as soon as possible. So, and she said that they're just about through with phase 1A and moving on to phase 1B after that, which is going to be a different list of people, but vaccinations are going well. At some point, I would like to have the discussion about unlocking the front doors and opening up the building to the public. I know the city of Devil's Lake has talked about doing that following the Martin Luther King holiday on the 18th and reopening their offices on the 19th, on that Tuesday. And I guess as numbers continue to go down, I think that would be a prudent thing for us to follow. Thoughts? Questions?
Have we, I don't recall if we talked with Carrie at the last meeting when the state's planning on trying to do jury trials and things like that again. I guess I haven't asked her, so.
July?
Okay, so it's a ways out.
I thought they had some trials scheduled for next week. Maybe they weren't jury trials.
Yeah,
they just bench trials.
Yeah, they would do a bench trial if they don't have it. I'm just curious, because you know that's one thing for sure we have to, you know, we've been working around it before, but if we could be able to do that, that would be something that would at least right. Put into consideration, obviously.
Well, I think we have a pretty good system in place protecting our workers. With plexiglass, we have the hand sanitizer dispensers on every floor. I think masks would still be mandatory requirement for entering the building. I think would be appropriate. But I haven't heard a whole lot of objections. As long as they have adequate personal protective supplies on hand for people, and people understand it, and don't think that people have been very accepting to the fact that we have been closed other than by appointments only. But I think they're ready to be able to walk in the front doors without having to call somebody to have an appointment to come in or to be let in. I'm open for discussion.
Was that the last meeting that we decided to address the issue at the second meeting in January? Can we talk about that?
We did talk about it. Yeah, I mean, we can do a few.
Let's see where the numbers go from Christmas. We haven't really seen that yet.
Right. No. I think the last meeting we talked about was going to go through Christmas, New Year,
and then see what the main team is.
By then we'll know what the numbers look like after Christmas.
I think that second meeting in January will give us some good input, and then we can either do, you know, the thought process of opening up after Martin Luther King holiday, or you can even push it back to the following Monday or something to give ourselves time to get everything put together. But I think it's reasonable to, like I said, wait another week or two, and then we'll see how the numbers play out from Christmas.
because I'm hoping we won't get a bump.
Chris?
Stand corrected, Carrie says, there were some changes, everything is seized completely through 110, so the 10th of this month for certain. They're gonna do some reviewing and talk later in June.
That's Porter's?
That's the Porter's.
So it'll probably be good to have, get Carrie in the loop too, to see when they're gonna start talking about jury trials, so that we just have that input.
Candy, what do you think the people in the courthouse feel?
It's all right.
Look at it.
Some would rather see it closed, some would rather see it open.
Look at it, maybe think about it, maybe that's what you want.
I think that would certainly be reasonable, you know, that puts us 3 weeks past Christmas, 2 weeks past New Year's.
Yeah, which is more of a lot.
Yep. The incubation period should be over. Chris, will you work with departments and see what PPEs they need or would like and help them get that ordered?
Sure.
Thank you. And I do think that the health department is continuing to use the Memorial Building for vaccinations, using Lever Self for testing, vaccinations for COVID shots in the Memorial Building. They still do their regular vaccinations for flu and what have you, immunizations in their offices upstairs. They have no plans on doing COVID vaccinations in-house, other than over at the Memorial Building. I think we found out yesterday, and Paula could probably confirm this, that fishing tournament is not going to have any activities in the Memorial Building. They decided that they're going to err on the side of abundance of caution and do things virtually. Most of their things that they generally did at the Memorial Building was registration, the chili feed, the prize drawings, the, you know, the tournament, and bands. So, but it was a 3-day type of event that they started that Thursday and went through Saturday evening or Saturday night. So I think they have decided to do everything virtually this year on the abundance of caution. So anything else on COVID-19 discussion? Everybody in communication with their department heads and portfolios and about their employees and whether they're telecommuting or working from home or things that they need to do to keep their staff and themselves and the public safe with in doing business. I think everybody's doing a really good job with that. So I feel pretty good with where our numbers have been going. And thank you to staff for making those sacrifices to that's been required. Any other old or unfinished business? If not, moving on to new business. Great sadness that we lost a member of the Ramsey County representative to the Garrison Conservancy District. John Curl passed away the day after Christmas. His funeral was last Saturday. John served Ramsey County on that Garrison board since 1999. That is an elected position. Every 4 years, John was halfway through his current term of that he was re-elected to in 2018. By law, by statute, Ramsey County contributes $1 million to the Garrison Conservancy District every year and has since 1965, I believe it was. So for the past 56 years, we've contributed to that. And I guess, when there's a vacancy within that position, the county commission appoints somebody to that position. That board meets quarterly. They're made up of 28 different county districts representatives. So we'd be one of Ramsey County, be one of 28. And it stretches all the way from Williams County and the upper northwest corner of the state, all the way down to Richland County in the southeastern part of the state. Kind of has that center swath of the state of North Dakota. Every county district member is a part of a subcommittee. I think they have four different subcommittees that are, and then their chairmen of those subcommittees make up their executive committee. The executive committee meets an additional four times per year. And the subcommittees meet generally the morning of their regular board meetings. So it becomes a full day of one meeting, but, they've been doing all those virtually. Normally they would do those in Clarington where their district offices are located. Questions on that? Should we just put a letter or a advertisement online, social media, paper maybe, to accept nominations for that appointment?
I had a phone call from Dwayne DeCray yesterday, and he said we can go proceed on how we want to do it. Or somebody advertised, that was a good idea. The next meeting is this Friday.
So we're gonna miss that. So I see that's what we're trying
to do. He said they've started the pipeline and they're digging it out of Missouri by, I think he said Washburn. Is that where it's at?
It is in Washburn. They're doing the casement, they call it, and they have to drill down right along the side of the Missouri where they're gonna have their intake. They're doing a bid opening in January for the pipeline. They're building a pipeline from Washburn to Lake Ashtabula to provide water to the Red River Valley. Years ago, you know, the original idea behind the Old Garrison Conservancy District was a water supply project for eastern North Dakota. Irrigation for, I think initially it was 1.5 million acres of farmland, and then it was restoration of bodies of water that had been devastated by the 30s drought, including Devil's Lake. Devil's Lake was always included in that plan, the original plan. Since then, since the 86 and the 2000 reauthorization plans through Congress, most of that stuff has been eliminated except for the pipeline project from the Lake Scott-Rio Missouri River to eastern North Dakota into Ashtabula, north of Valley City. But I think it certainly behooves the county to have somebody representing us since we contribute money to that organization each and every year. So we'll take nominations for that. Maybe leave that open until our first meeting in February. I do have some people that have shown some interest, kind of. They haven't committed fully to it, but they wanted to look more into it and kind of see what type of commitments it would be. And basically it would just be to fulfill the remainder of John's term. Whether they want to run for re-election at that time, they would have to do so by filing, similar to any other elected office, by submitting a petition for the primary, I believe, in 2022, and then It's a general election in the fall of that year. Do we want to,
Our first meeting in February is the 2nd, so that gives what? Basically, not quite a month now, but I don't know. So basically gives a month then for people to send a letter of interest in and things of that nature, so. I guess like, that's the route I guess I would prefer is advertising for it, have people send us letters of interest, a resume, things like that, and then we can decide at that first meeting in February, at least in my opinion, how we want to, I mean, if we want to interview people, if we want to just select somebody at that point, however. At least we'll have people show an interest in it and see. There might be one person, it might be 20 people.
Being familiar with Garrison's version, what it's done for Ramsey County, it's pretty damn minimal.
But, you know, we are sending money there every year, so we should have somebody there to make sure at least getting some of it back here at least again, so.
I know, since I've been on the commission, there was a time a few years ago that they talked about pulling out of here. About what it went to the top at the commission.
It's incredibly difficult to do. Once we got on there through legislation, it's very difficult for counties to withdraw from it.
All you do is don't send your check.
Well, it's not quite that easy. Because I think Riggs County did that a few years ago and got sued and then lost that battle in court.
I'm not in favor of that. I'm not going with that.
Granted, we weren't given what was initially promised to us, and I think we need a strong voice on there to remind them of that. And when the Red River is dry, chances are so is Devil's Lake. And, you know, to lose the tremendous recreational fishery that we have, the river was back flowing a year after it went dry. It took decades for Devil's Lake to replenish itself where it could sustain a fishery. From the 40s to the 60s.
It's probably going to happen again.
And it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when it'll happen again, and that's something that we have to continue to fight for and advocate for state and federally, and this is one of the avenues to do it. Unfortunately, we're one of 28, but if we could convince the other 27, or a majority of those 27, that maybe a $2 billion pipeline to Fargo isn't the best way to spend that money, or to move water from point A to point B. Maybe it's take a better look at what was initially designed with some enhanced technology features that could potentially ease the concerns that they had in Canada and Minnesota and other parts that objected to what was initially proposed.
Do we need a motion to advertise? Then I'd make that motion.
All right.
Second.
We moved and advertised to fill the vacant Garrison version position. And for appointment, looking at the first meeting in February, correct?
Yep.
All right. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Discussion on Devil's Lake Chamber membership. This is something that I asked to put up and put on, just kind of an oversight that noticed that Ramsey County was not a member of the chamber. I've been attending those meetings on a regular basis since I was first elected 4 years ago, and I think it's a wonderful organization. It does a fantastic job. Paula Bristed is here, their executive director. They do a lot of things for our business community and our community in general. And I think it would be very beneficial to be a part of it. And it's really, inexpensive for us to do so. $235 is the membership fee for a government entity, and Paula brought along a annual report to the community. And they really do do a nice job for the community. They have a lot of events that they schedule and participate in, one of which will be the extension roundup today. They help sponsor that and serve meals, so at the extension roundup. So you guys are missing out today, Paula.
Yes, I feel horrible about some of my favorite things to do.
It is a fun opportunity for chamber members to be a part of them. But I wanted to bring that up for discussion. We probably, since we're spending money, need a motion to become a member. Certainly open up for discussion.
Can I speak, Jeff? I'm not
sure. Absolutely.
I just want to apologize. I know Jeff brought this to my attention, but I actually didn't feel as though this, it falls on me. I've been the director now for 7 years, and when Jeff called, I was just shocked more than anything that family was not a member. It was always my assumption that you were. So I'll take full credit for this error, and I just feel horrible that you never were a member, because I just assumed you were. So as it goes, never assume anything correct. But I've always treated you as though you guys were members. We've always done business with you. We've always treated you as though you were. This 235 really, you know, is just, you know, basically the gesture that we have to go through to get you on our rolls. But we've always, you know, felt as though the county was just like one of our other members. We've worked with you so closely. All the members here, both, you know, Adam and Jeff, we've always worked really closely. I hope to work with Blaine as well. So just the gesture of the membership is what we need to get you in our roles and to you know, work with you the same. So I apologize. I truly do feel as though this is my error.
Is there any other government entity that you could approach there?
Well, yeah, the city is always a member and always has been. Old Devils are, I don't believe there is. But I certainly will scrutinize my close to 300 members a little closer. I'm sure there was probably an invoice that was sent out and maybe never got looked at. I'm certainly not pointing fingers because I'm the director, so I'll put it all the blame on myself. But I do appreciate Jeff.
It was one of those assumptions that I had as well, you know, until I started really delving into it and going, where's our listing as a member? And so when we did some checking, yeah, I found out that we weren't, so an official member anyway, so.
Well, I'll make a motion that we become members of the chamber, which we didn't think about that.
Second. Who is on the chamber board? Adam, are you?
No. Jeff's our representative.
I've been on it for the last 4 years, really enjoyed it. It's a great group of people. Right now, is it Kale?
Kale's
the president. Kale Strummy. Past presidents have been Ryan Yoder and Aaron Wood. And
Adam, were you on once?
I was right after I got on the commission, yeah, but then when I took four of Devil's Lake, then we gave Jeff.
Yeah.
That's because the meetings are during the day, so I can only take one meeting during the day.
Good. Been moved and seconded that we become members for the Devil's Lake Chamber. Any further discussion? If not, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Thank you, Paula, thank you for everything that you and Susie and your staff do out at the chamber offices. Well done. You know, it's been a difficult year for you and the chamber members as well. So keeping everybody informed of what's going on and how to deal with all the COVID issues that have arisen over the past 10 months, 12 months. Thank you. Anything else on chamber? Paula, did you have anything else?
No.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any Thank you very much. Approve the 2021 mileage rates. And these mileage rates have changed based on OMB.
Down to 56.
And do 56 cents a mile.
I'll make a motion to update the mileage rates. Down to 56.
We move, do we have a second?
Yeah, second.
Moving second that we approve the OMB state rate of mileage for 56 cents a mile. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Both same sign. Motion carries. Visitors and delegations. Chris, did you have anything else from EM? Any other visitors online, Steve? No? All right. Reports on portfolios. Should we start over to my left, Mr. Commissioner Wakefield?
So I got to press up. I have not talked to any of my department heads. I meant to do that this week. I will do so, but seeing as I haven't talked to them, they're not reporting anything. But while you're on me, I'll just add my announcement. I will not be here physically for the next commission meeting because I'm going to be on personal vacation. So I'm going to be here. So I will see if I can work with Candy to be on the phone call, but I won't be physically present.
A lot of work the same day as the end of the year. I think the government can do that, but I'll go. I won't visit that place too often when we sign checks, so.
I talked with the recorder and treasurer, there was nothing there. Fair board haven't met for the meeting yet. Lake Access, what I got from them. I wasn't able to make a meeting, but I talked to Susie. Year-round fishing cleaning stations will stay open as long as the guidelines are known or followed over. Mike Grassgard is working on a grant for putting in three stairs over the riprap for summer fishing. Maybe not know what areas would be covered yet. It's just out there to see if they can get a grant for it. Snow removal for Lake Access was awarded to John Dowell at $3,500. Access point 6 miles Lakewood East Bay heading their boat landing and then behind Hops. And the only concern that they had was 72nd Avenue to Mike's Lake Road. That got repaired this last summer with a whole bunch of issues going on. Somebody closed the road, a couple of townships. The only concern she was at is the signs were removed after they fixed it, but they were just thrown in the ditch and she was very dry. If they were worried, maybe they would be pulled back up next spring. Why weren't they totally removed? It was her question, but other than that, they followed all the guidelines of game of fish and game part. I think they paid 25%. There's information out there that they had a letter they agreed with. That was the only concern she had, that hopefully someone's not going to just pull the sign back across the road to the spring.
Alright, it's good.
Trying to think if I've got a, not had anything since the second meeting in December, really not much. At home, Christmas and New Year's. I talked to Karina a while back, and we're going to school here. Extension, obviously. Roundup's going on, we've talked about that already. I partook in a couple of the videos last night. Good information, as it always is, a different format, but good information, so hopefully next year we get back together again. But it's still better than nothing. I'm glad that they're making the effort to give us, you know, to still have that information out there so we can go find it and learn a little bit of something about marketing and agronomics and everything that's going to be going on this next year, so. Other than that, it's all I got.
Didn't have a whole lot. Tammy's been doing a fantastic job with all the building auditor stuff. Chris has got, he's busy with all that stuff. Veteran service officer, Bryce has been busy. That's an extremely busy office, and you know, and phone calls come in to that office, and I think Bryce is doing a very stand-up job on everything there. Law enforcement center, I did talk to Rob about COVID numbers, and he said that, you know, a month ago they had some outbreaks, but last week when I talked to him, he said they're down to no COVID cases within the facility. So they had one staff that was out on quarantine, but other than that, they've been down to clear it all up. So they were very pleased with those numbers. They're going to start with their Binax rapid testing. They were testing once a week through the PCR, through the Department of Health, or the Lake Region District Health, doing that test, but they're going to start doing their own Binax testing, the rapid testing, which will be good so they can, they don't have to isolate somebody for 14 days or 6 days before they get a test back. They can do a quick test and get it back relatively quick. They're getting all their testing in line, and I think either this week or next week they'll be starting with their Binax testing, their rapid test kits soon, so which will be good. I know the colleges will be doing theirs. I'm not sure if the Devil's Lake schools will be implementing that at their. I know that's something they've talked about, but so far so good. Airport numbers are still, you know, they've been increasing, but they're still about 50% from where they were a year ago. So I think as people start vacationing a little more, becoming things start opening up nationwide, people will start taking a few more vacations here and there. So, and hopefully people continue to line up and get vaccinated. Other than that, that's about it. From my aspect, next meeting would be the 19th of January, 5:30 p.m. Anything else for the good of the order? Motion to adjourn.